Now, tonight on Good Sorts, we're taking you inside a gym you can only join if you have breast cancer. It's the only one in New Zealand, and it's based at the University of Otago's Physical Education Department. The founder of the gym is Dr. Lynnette Jones, and she is this week's Good Sorts.
Anne-Marie comes twice a week. Hayes is not far behind, and Lois has been coming 5 years.
Well, I can't do many more of these.
They exercise a little.
It's got to come to my mid-chest.
And talk a lot.
The discussions about anything and everything.
They even chat about death.
I wasn't supposed to see Christmas.
Anne-Marie's thought a lot about that lately. She has terminal breast cancer. Yeah. She's philosophical.
You just laugh about it. Other people probably take it harder than I do.
Hayes has breast cancer too, and Lois as well.
I wouldn't be without this place.
Natalie's got secondary cancer.
I am technically, well, and practically, incurable.
All in all, there's 140 of them, all referred from their oncologist, all with breast cancer, all at the same gym.
We come for the company, the laugh, the information.
Yes, there we go, Lois.
It's a gym exclusively for breast cancer patients.
Just relaxing on the way up.
It's called XPINT. It's the brainchild of University of Otago's Dr. Lynnette Jones.
There's a lot of people survive cancer, they don't all survive well.
Dr. Jones had been studying diabetes, but when she helped a friend through cancer, she saw she could help.
It's a living legacy to a, you know, an incredibly strong woman.
Chrissy Marney died 3 months after the program started.
Because of that, I have a very personal involvement.
The theory is simple. We're better when we move more. Like Hazy couldn't raise her arm over her head. Dr. Jones went further than just a gym, though. She now teaches a paper on exercise and cancer recovery. Then she handpicks students to work with the patients.
It's surprising how many of them leave the clinic at the end of the paper with several new mothers and grandmothers because they all get adopted.
Are we breathing?
That's Summer O'Shea, a former student who now works here.
It's not a sad place at all. It's definitely full of laughter. And so I guess I go home feeling quite uplifted.
Summer tells me, though, the worst part is when people don't return.
Putting on that brave face in here and maybe needing to tell some of the ladies who are also close with those people.
Lifesaver. We'd all be dead if we didn't have our gym.
The gym that provides an antidote for everyone.
This is my survival package.
Hayden Jones.
It's family.
One News.